Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Monday Night Raw. Live here from Grand Rapids, Michigan, ladies and gentlemen, we are here on Monday Night Raw, the night after Money in the Bank, actually two nights after. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I cannot wait to see what's going to be happening here tonight, here on Monday Night Raw. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, let's get it on, let's get it started. But ladies and gentlemen, Roman Reigns will be coming out here up next, ladies and gentlemen, to have a certain conversation. We have no idea what he's going to be coming out here for. We're going to find out right up next, ladies and gentlemen, right here on Monday Night Raw. And as you can see, I actually figured out a way how to actually play the music in the background the correct way this time. And that's all super low. But so now when I do my match card in the near future, we actually be realistic. I want to apologize for the old school version I used to do it. But it's going to sound better now. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Anyways, that will be happening, ladies and gentlemen, at the paper. What am I talking about? Roman Reigns actually has something to say. We have no idea what he's going to be talking about, though. But he actually was in the Money in the Bank ladder match this past he was actually here on Saturday night at the pay-per-view, ladies and gentlemen. So the only question is, what will he have to say? What will be his reaction to everything here tonight, here at Monday Night Raw? We're gonna find out here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. That is for sure. Hold on, express the wrong way. Hold on. No bad. Yeah, it sounds like almost over, but it's going to start up anyway. We're getting ready to start the match. Or the whole storyline thing. The Roman Reigns will be coming out here right now, ladies and gentlemen, up next here on Monday Night Raw. Alright, you shut up. Anyways, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here is a Roman Reigns. Oh my god, that was loud. Hold on, I want to apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. I did not mean to do that. Jesus Christ. That was louder than loud for like no apparent reason. I mean, here is the underdog. I mean, here is the big dog, Roman Reigns, here on Monday Night Raw. What does he have to say here tonight? We're going to find out. I've been quiet a long time. I've been holding back both in the ring and out. But that stops now. So I'm calling out Dean Ambrose to settle things once and for all. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. In case y'all didn't know, Dean Ambrose was trying to help Roman Reigns last week in a match, but he actually, you know, made him lose by accident. Oh wait a minute! Here comes the lunatic French. Dang, this is happening quickly. This is happening really quickly. This is escalating fast. I mean, Dean Ambrose is already out here. Here you go. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is how we're gonna start Monday Night Raw here. Roman Reigns calling out Dean to the Ambrose here tonight on Monday Night Raw. What does Dean Ambrose have to say to start off Raw, ladies and gentlemen? Roman Reigns was kind of ticked about something. We have no idea what he was ticked about. Exactly. It's kind of the whole thing. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, ladies and gentlemen. Dean Ambrose, what do you have to say to Roman after calling him out like that? I have to wonder what I'm doing out here. Sounds to me like you've got an axe to grind. Let's not waste any more time, all right? You want to say something to me? Let's have it out. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Ambrose. You see, the thing is that the Money in the Bank, they kept messing each other up in the match, and that's the reason why Seth Rollins ended up winning, even though all three of them are teammates, and Seth Rollins is the Mr. Money in the Bank, so I have no idea why this is all happening right now. It's become abundantly clear to me that I'm the only one who cares about success in this pair. I take this tag team seriously, like I do all matters in my life. You, though, you just don't care, do you? Do you have any idea how hard it is to pair with somebody like that? That's why it's time for me to move on. Ladies and gentlemen, why is he doing this? I've regretted this since the moment we actually stepped into the ring together. In a way, I knew this would happen. But being the optimist that I am, I gave you the benefit of the doubt. But it turns out you're not just a failure. You're delusional as well. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, oh my God, you're saying that Roman Reigns is delusional. Oh man, he's going in on Roman. No amount of sweet talking or promises will get me to change my mind. Once it's set, it's set. As the saying goes, when one door closes, another door opens. This is my chance to step through a new door. It's time to move forward. No more looking backwards. Heck, this could be a good thing for you too. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Roman Reigns, they've been brothers for 5 or 6 years. Sooner or later, this was going to happen. It's actually better this way, because now the WWE Universe will get to see who the better man is. Although, truthfully, you already know. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Roman Reigns saying that they already know who the better man is. Dean Ambrose has nothing to say to that, ladies and gentlemen. Dean has nothing to say. He couldn't find an answer, ladies and gentlemen. Roman Reigns shut him up a little bit, ladies and gentlemen. That was kind of messed up. He shut him up. It's alright though. I ain't mad. But ladies and gentlemen, there's gonna be a little small tournament going on for the women's division, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. It's gonna be Billie Kay versus Becky Lynch to start it off tonight, but also Ember Moon and Dana Brooke will be in the match to see who will go against Asuka at next month's pay-per-view, Extreme Rules, ladies and gentlemen. So I cannot wait to find out. I can't wait to find out what's going to happen and who is going to be going against Asuka. Billie Kay was seriously close to beating her at Money in the Bank this past Saturday night. So I don't know. Sorry, I was reaching for my phone. But I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know how it's going to happen. All I know. Apologize for that. Okay, my recording's fine. I don't know what happened to that, but we want to apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. That was a blooper. You're on Monday Night Raw this Thanksgiving, but here you go, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Monday Night Raw live here from the nation's capital. So no, we're actually in Michigan. Here comes Nightclub, ladies and gentlemen, as we like to call her. She has that nightclub music right going on, you know what I mean? This is why we call it nightclub. But here we go, and apparently Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose are not the Shield anymore, and that was fast lived. There's Peyton Royce right behind her iconic duo partner, Billie Kay, ladies and gentlemen. Billie Kay, like we were saying before, was very close to actually winning the Raw Women's Championship, but unfortunately was not able to find an answer at the last minute. So, you know, it was really close. I was actually kind of surprised at how close she was. She kicked her a couple times. She almost pinned her. But unfortunately, it was not enough to put away Asuka for that Raw Women's Championship. But if she does go again at Extreme Rules, it might well happen. It just might happen, ladies and gentlemen. But just to let everybody know, at that pay-per-view, at that pay-per-view, that match will be, I can't get my words out for some reason. That match is going to be, Extreme Rules match, obviously. So that would be pretty cool to see, Billie Kay. But that would be also cool to see Becky Lynch and Asuka go against each other in an Extreme Rules match. That would be pretty darn sick to see at Extreme Rules, so that would be pretty cool. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here is Becky Lynch, ladies and gentlemen, the person who cannot find an answer, but we'll see if we're able to find an answer tonight. We're going to find out here tonight, here on Monday Night Raw. Hopefully she'll be able to find an answer, because I got to feel bad for this chick, man. Like, she just can't find an answer at all when it comes to that championship, man. She just can't find that money. She can't hit it right on the nose, you know what I mean? One of those situations. Who knows? Maybe she might stand tall tonight. She might be able to find an answer and then go against Ember Moon next week. That'd be pretty awesome to see. Or Dana Brooke. I mean, it could be either or tonight, because who knows who's going to win that match. But, you know. Also, there will be another contenders match to see who will be going against the Tag Team Champions, The Bar, at Extreme Rules. That'll be coming up later on tonight. Actually, after this match, actually, is that close in time, actually. So I don't know why I said later on tonight was actually gonna be like literally up next. But I had this match. Ooh, dang, a punch right there. Oh, wait a minute. Becky Lynch with a clothesline right there to Billie Kay. And Billie Kay cannot find an answer early on, but no, Billie Kay reverses now. Here we go. She goes to the rope, and oh, and a clothesline. Great clothesline from Billie Kay. This could be the pinfall here, but no, it's not. And I'm ticking right now, I ain't gonna lie. The way I sounded. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, she missed again, unfortunately. Wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at that back suplex. And she wasn't a back suplex, but whatever. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, Becky Lynch could stand tall here tonight. She could win. Oh, look at this. Her signature move just a little bit. That's actually technically her signature move. Here we go. And oh, dang, that axe handle right to the face of Billy Kay. And Billy Kay in deep trouble now. Billy Kay getting ready to be suplexed back in the ring. Oh, wait a minute. No, she's not. She's going to suplex her back into the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, by the way, one of our superstars here on this roster is the cover superstar for... Oh, dang! Ladies and gentlemen, oh my god! Hold on a second. One, two... No, it's a kick out from Billy Kay. It's a kick out from Becky Lynch. I'm sorry. Becky... Oh, ladies and gentlemen, she's just tearing her up right now with all these moves. But anyways, like I was saying, AJ Styles is the official cover star for WWE 2K19, which will be coming out... The earliest has ever been out, which will be October 9th. But if you get the deluxe edition, it will be coming out on October the 5th. So that's really, really early. If you're a wrestling fan, then you know that's pretty early. Even though the old SmackDown game, I think it was SmackDown 1, came out in February. So it's not the earliest of all time, technically. But in recent history, that's pretty darn early. Like that's the first Friday of October. So, you know, that's pretty darn early. So that means that Hell in a Cell, this will be the first time that, this will be the first, no wait, Hell in a Cell will happen, my bad, I'm sorry, Hell in a Cell will happen, actually. Hell in a Cell will actually be on this game, because that's in September. So, actually TLC will actually be the first pay-per-view, just like this year on 2K18, TLC will be the first pay-per-view of 2K19, WWE 2K19. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen, now Becky Lynch with a clothesline, Becky Lynch... And Billy Kay going back and forth in a back and forth battle here tonight here on Raw. And Billy Kay has to do something here in order to wake herself up. In order to go on to Extreme Rules and fight again. Fight another day to become the Raw Women's Champion. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Look at Becky Lynch. Becky, what are you doing? Oh, Becky Lynch, now she got it. That was actually kind of like a good fake out, I guess. Wait a minute. Now Billy Kay with a reversal. Wait a second here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, the impact of that. And I think it's going to be a rope break right here. No, it's not. The ref didn't see it, I guess. But ladies and gentlemen, oh my God. Did you just see that? But look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. And Billy Kay has her down. And Billy Kay not playing any games here tonight here on Raw. Here we go. Look at this. And Billy Kay. And now she has the pin. One. A hook of the leg. Now it's a kick out. Pretty much right away. Ladies and gentlemen, Billy Kay. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. And, Peyton Royce. Peyton Royce here. Oh, wait a minute. And, and I kicked right to the face, and Peyton Royce was right there to help her. Now it's a rope break. Hurry up. Not hurry up. I mean, right away, I meant to say, darn it. And ladies and gentlemen, she would have probably had the win right there if it wasn't for that rope break. But Peyton Royce did help out in that sort of situation there. And, look at this. And wait a minute. Look at this right here. What is she doing right here? Wait a minute. Wait a second, ladies and gentlemen. And now she has it in. She has it in. Oh, no, it's a rope break. She has her foot on the rope right away. Wait a minute. She hit the ref by accident. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, she just drop kicked her. And ladies and gentlemen, now Billy Kay was knocked out right there. Oh, wait a minute. And now Billy Kay. Wait a minute. Billy Kay with a roll up. Billy Kay with a roll up. This could be the pinfall. No. And she kicks out right away. Dang. These are some quick behind kickouts. That was a reversal. I actually didn't know. She reversed it. And there goes a drop kick from Becky Lynch. And now Becky Lynch could get the win here tonight here on Raw. As always, we like repeat ourselves like 24/7 here tonight. I want to apologize for that. We just keep on repeating ourselves. I don't know why. Here we go. And now Becky Lynch going to the top now. And a drop kick from the top rope. Not a drop kick. A leg drop. One hook of the leg. No, it's a kick out from Billy Kay. And Billy Kay almost lost again right there. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. And wait a second. Reversal. And a roll up. Here's the pin. No, it's a kick out from Becky Lynch again. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, she's looking at her. And a clothesline. And a great clothesline. And now, she can possibly get this now, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait a minute. No, and Becky Lynch takes her to the corner. Becky Lynch takes her to the corner. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Look, oh, wait a minute. She just jumped up there like it was nothing. Hold on a second. And now, oh, ladies and gentlemen, Becky Lynch. Oh, my God. Is she okay? Oh, my God, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my God. That has to be it. That's it. She's dead. Here's the pin. One. Hook of the leg. Three, and it's over. Billy Kay advances. Dang. Oh, my God. What a finish. That had to hurt, ladies and gentlemen. She hurt the heck. She had to hurt that abdomen. That abdomen has to be in a lot of pain right now. Oh, my gosh. That looked like it hurt. Ladies and gentlemen, there you go. Here's the first one. Oh, that was the first one that would have finished her off, but her hand was under the rope. Good catch by the ref. Good catch by the ref right there. But ladies and gentlemen, here's the roll up. She kicked that right away, actually, so I don't even know why they're actually showing this. that was like a quick kick out. But look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this move right here. Boom! Right there, off the top rope. What a great move from Becky Lynch here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Great move.
Great move.
And then there was a kick out, ladies and gentlemen. She almost had her. That was a roll-up, ladies and gentlemen, by the way, that almost had her as well. That was a two count right there, but she didn't get the three. Oh, wait. Dang, the ref is all up on her. Back up. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, Billy Kay advances to next week's Monday Night Raw to go against either Dana Brooke or Ember Moon next week here on Raw. And I wonder, who will be the one? You get what I'm saying? It's just like Royal Rumble 2010. I believe that was a catchphrase for that. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we're not going to actually play the song from our show because we have no idea what's going on. So no, we're going to try it again. I'm going to see. Hold on. Let's try it out. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, anyways. Turn that down because it's not the song. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, up next is going to be to see who will be the number contenders for the Raw Tag Team Champions. Will it be the Bullet Club or the Club, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, or will it be Havoc, which is Kevin Owens and Fandango, alongside Apollo Crews and Kalisto, ladies and gentlemen. They are looking to be the most dominant tag team. I don't know why Fandango still wearing that police outfit. What is that with Tyler Breeze anymore? So it's kind of backwards. It doesn't really make any sense. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that's up next here on Monday to the night of To the Raw. I can't wait. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, just in case people want to know what the theme song was to my Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen, it's probably going to be in the link in the description. But it's Break Me Down by Our Waking Hour, by the way. Just let everybody know that. Just in case people ask, but no one knows. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And here comes the Club. They are a club here in the WWE. Of course, they're not there, the other person. They keep doing that for some weird reason. It's like a big glitch that keeps happening here on Raw. But we don't understand. Just go with it, all right? We don't understand why, but it just happens. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson, the visible Carl Anderson here tonight. We love you, 2K. We just love you. We love you, 2K18. We just love you. What a great game. But that happens for absolutely no reason whatsoever. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, the Bullet Club is back, ladies and gentlemen. Later on tonight, by the way, Kurt Angle has announced. That's not... Okay, there we go. Sorry, my thing was acting stupid. But anyways, on my phone. What was I going to say? But yeah, later on tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we'll actually have a match between... We're actually going to have a match between... I can't get my words out for some freaking reason. It's going to be a match between... it's going to be a Fatal 4-Way. Just confirmed from Kurt Angle. We're actually getting news on it now. There will be a Fatal 4-Way match to see who will go against Brock Lesnar at the Extreme Rules pay-per-view next month, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, Cody Rhodes, And then the returning from injury, Braun Strowman, will be here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. So, whoa, that was creepy. Apollo Crews, come on, man. He just came out of seeing nowhere. But ladies and gentlemen, who will be the one to win that match to go against Brock Lesnar for the Universal Champion? So Brock Lesnar on our show, ladies and gentlemen, is not going to get paid $1 million just to sit around. He's going to defend that title. So that's what's happening. He's defending that title at Extreme Rules. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, at Extreme Rules, he is defending that title. It will go down, no doubt about it. So I cannot wait to see what will happen here tonight. Who's going to win that match? Who is going to be the one? And also, ladies and gentlemen, to also confirm, just to let everybody know, tonight, that match is actually going to be a Fatal 4-Way False Count Anywhere, which means it will be creepy, because anybody can win at any place at the, I was going on the map, like it's GTA. Anybody can win at any part of the map. Why did I say map? Any part of the arena, I'm about to say. It's False Count Anywhere. So it's a False Count Anywhere Fatal 4-Way match, ladies and gentlemen. They get pinned on top of the stage, and they don't even know about it, so they didn't even pay attention. I just realized I was supposed to skip this. But, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Fandango is running down there. I don't know why. He's supposed to be out there with Kevin Owens and them. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And here comes the tag team match. Who is going to win? Who will be the one here tonight, here on Monday Night Raw? Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And now Kevin Owens and Luke Gallows going one-on-one here tonight, here on Monday Night Raw. Well, not one-on-one, but they're starting off the match. Here we go. And now Kevin Owens. Oh, Kevin Owens kicks him right there, ladies and gentlemen. And for some weird reason, for the first time in Kevin Owens' career here in the WWE, he's kind of the hero in a certain way. Because no one likes the Bullet Club. I mean, they like him, but but they're kind of hills right now. So, ladies and gentlemen, I am really I'm really kind of curious on what's going to happen here tonight and how the Bullet Club is going to become one of the biggest superstars here in the WWE. Oh, and look at that from Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens could finish Luke Gallows right here. No, he cannot. Not that early on. I don't know what he was going for. Not that early on. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, a kick out right there. Oh, and look at that from Luke. Luke Gallows now staring down. Oh, Kevin Owens, and Kevin Owens got kicked right there from Luke. And now Luke Gallows has to put him right there. He's going to, and a great double team. Great double team from Luke Gallows and Karl Anderson. And now Karl Anderson is outside of the ring. Oh, this is unfair. This is unfair. Wait a minute. And, ladies and gentlemen, and this is just an insult. This is just an insult to Kevin Owens. And now Kevin Owens is put back into the ring now. Now he's in deep trouble. He has to find an answer here tonight here on Raw, if he wants to become tag team champions. Oh, man. If he wants to become tag team champions with his partner in crime. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and Kevin Owens takes him down. Takes him down now. And oh, and he gets Karl Anderson. And now Kevin Owens is in the driver's seat. He's back now, ladies and gentlemen. A part of the team Havoc. And Havoc, are no stranger to the tag team title scene, except it was the other two. Who is actually, ladies and gentlemen, now he's outside of the ring now. He's outside of the ring. He's saying, what's the problem? He wants to know what's going on. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, it was the other side. It was actually Apollo Crews and Kalisto who were the tag team champions at that time. But now it might be Kevin Owens. And wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Kevin. Kevin. Oh, my God, Kevin. Are you okay? Ladies and gentlemen, I think he's a little bit hurt. Is he okay after that? That looked painful. Like, Kevin, what's wrong with you? Why did you do that? Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on a second. And now Kevin Owens looking to do something here on the barricade right there. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, right on the barricade to Luke Gallows is so nonchalant. That looked like a hurt. I mean, it probably did, most likely, but still. There has been no tags in this match so far. Pretty nice to see that sooner or later. Wait a minute. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, look at that. And ladies and gentlemen, here we go. And now he's taunting, saying, look at this guy right here. And Kevin Owens was tricking him. It's again, ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Owens hurts his arm right there trying to do it. But ladies and gentlemen, wait a minute. He's just going to tag him out. He's going to tag him right now. And Fandango goes to the top now. Fandango's going to the top. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen, Fandango, and a drop kick from Fandango. And Fandango is now taunting the fans. And now Fandango's out there, ladies and gentlemen, taunting the fans, showing them some love. He's showing them some love here tonight on Monday Night Raw. Here we go. Kevin Owens, team of Havoc, is wreaking havoc here tonight on Raw. Wait a minute. Oh, and Fandango now. Fandango coming with a suplex. Coming up soon. Oh, no. To a theater near you. Oh, and a clothesline. What a vicious clothesline right there from Luke Gallows. Luke Gallows should not be wasting that much time right now. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Now the tech goes in. And now Carl Anderson is in the ring now. Here we go. He goes to the rope now. Here we go. And a kick right to the face. Ladies and gentlemen, Carl Anderson. Carl. Oh, he's doing some shotgun references, ladies and gentlemen. He's the Bullet Club. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. And now the Bullet Club is being held back. Ladies and gentlemen, now he's saying, oh, wait a minute, Carl Anderson's now going to the top now. Now he's going to the top. Oh, wait, oh, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wait a minute. And now, oh, Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens is now, oh, wait a minute. Oh, and he didn't know he was going to try to go back to the ring. But he didn't know that that was happening. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. And now Fandango puts him back into the ring here. Here we go. Off the top. Coming up towards him. Here we go. And oh, and a dropkick now. And now he does a dropkick to Carl. Carl. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, wait. Reversal now. Reversal from Carl Anderson. Carl going for a move here. Oh, wait a second. Look at Fandango. Fandango reverses into his own move of his own. Here we go. Fandango. Boom. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen. And now Fandango has to get him over. Oh, look at this. Look at this right here. Look at this. Fandango, ladies and gentlemen. And wait a second. Fandango now in the driver's seat. Look at Fandango. Look at Fandango. And oh, ladies and gentlemen, reversal. Oh, I don't think he's even going to get it, actually. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I'm getting so tired of tag team matches when it does that. Like, they roll the ring like 90% of the time. Good God, man. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Now he's going back into the ring now. Here we go. And now, oh, look at this. Woo, boom, and a kick right to the face. I actually don't know why I screamed woo for it, but there we go, ladies and gentlemen. This could be it for Fandango. One, they cannot be advancing to Extreme Rules, and no, it's going to be a kick out now. And ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Here we go, Carl Anderson, he has him out in the corner now. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and he reversed it. Oh, and look at the elbow right to the face. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. I don't think he realizes, but no, man, come on now. And now he chokes him out. He's choking Fandango. Come on now. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Boom, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that right there. Wait a minute. He's going to go for it again. And he does it again. Come on now. This is ridiculous. Wait a minute. What is he doing? Oh, wait a minute. And Fandango with a reversal. Fandango. Here we go. Oh, and Fandango now. And now Fandango reversed it. Wait a minute. What is he doing? Oh, he has his hand on his arm. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. And that had to hurt. That had to hurt to Carl Anderson. Here we go. Oh, boom. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, here we go. Oh, wait a second. Oh, reverse it now. A tag team move's coming. Oh, wait a minute. Look at Kevin Owens jumping over the rope like that. Look at this. Oh, elbow. And now Kevin Owens is trying to prove that everybody. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. He tried. He didn't even know. Oh, wait a second. Look at this. Oh, man. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at this. Look at that right there from Luke Gallows. And now Luke Gallows here. Wait. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, and now he punches him to the corner again. Here we go. Oh. Oh, and look at that from Luke Gallows. And now Luke Gallows now. It's trying to get him. Oh, my freaking goodness gracious. That's annoying. That's so annoying. I always have to break kayfabe because of that one moment. It's so gosh dang annoying. I hate that. But anyways, I mean, it's more realistic, but still. Jesus Christ. All right. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, like we were actually trying to say, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Luke Gallows, he keeps doing the same thing for some weird reason. Here we go. And oh, and ladies and gentlemen, a kick right there to Luke. and Luke Gallows. Here we go, and oh, and he just keeps throwing him up in the air and just throwing him back down. Kevin Owens, I never seen Kevin Owens actually get lifted up like that, by the way. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, wait a second. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at that from Kevin Owens. And Kevin Owens, oh, look at this. The elbow from Kevin Owens. And Kevin gets him, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, goodness gracious, man. Good God. Ladies and gentlemen, Luke Gallows, I'm so tired of seeing him just do the same thing and just go outside the ring for no apparent reason. By like the slightest move. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin Owens finally caught him now. Here we go, and this could be it right here. And now Kevin Owens wants to advance. Oh, wait a second. Clothesline right there from Luke Gallows. Oh, what? What? That is so annoying. I keep saying it, but like, good God almighty, it's annoying. But ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Now Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens in deep trouble now. As he goes to the rope. Oh, dang. I was not expecting to see that. But ladies and gentlemen, here we go. What is he doing? What is he going for right now? Wait a minute. Oh, reversal. Wait a minute. Roll up right here from Kevin. Kevin Owens won. Kevin Owens. Oh, my God. And Kevin Owens having this going. Ladies and gentlemen, what was he even trying to do right there? What was Luke trying to do? But ladies and gentlemen, Havoc is going to Extreme Rules, and they're going to go for that title. They're going to win that title probably. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't even know what that was right there, by the way. Like, you couldn't even find an answer with that one. I don't know what the heck that was. I don't know what happened right there, but I don't even want to ask, honestly. But ladies and gentlemen, what a win. What a pinfall from Havoc. And now they're going to Extreme Rules. And they will be fighting for the tag team champions. I mean, tag team championships. I'm sorry. But Havoc. Havoc has done it. Kevin Owens finally has found an answer. He finally found an answer. Fandango's finally found an answer. Well, Fandango finally won his first championship. First of all, that's the number one thing we should put into place is, will he finally win a championship for once in his gosh dang life? But ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Havoc on their win tonight. What a match that was. Oh my. Hopefully the song doesn't play. I don't really feel like turning it back down. That's the thing. I don't feel like turning it back down. Of course it does. All right. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, up next here on Monday Night Raw. Up next here on Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen. I can't get my words out for some weird reason. But up next here on Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for Ember Moon and Dana Brooke to go one-on-one here tonight here on Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot wait to see what happens between these two superstars. It is going to be very, very awesome. It's going to be very, very big and cool. Dana Brooke, Ember Moon, one-on-one to see who goes against Billie Kay next week here on Raw.
The real question is, will Ember Moon, like, early on in her career here in WWE, I mean, on the main roster, actually become the number one contender? Or become champion, for that matter? That's the real question.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here is Ember Moon. Here is the moon who is Ember. And she is ready for some action here tonight on Monday Night Raw. I'm actually kind of excited for Extreme Rules. It's kind of all because, you know, I created a stage and I'm really proud with it. That's number one. That's the first thing. And there she is, ladies and gentlemen. I got to put the NXT Women's Championship off for real, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know why. I keep forgetting to take it off. But ladies and gentlemen, there is Ember Moon, ladies and gentlemen, the upcoming woman here. One of the upcoming women here in the WWE. Here on Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen. And I can clearly, I can extremely see her becoming one of the biggest superstars of all time here in WWE. Easily. I don't see it being an impossible thing for her, or an impossible obstacle for her here in the WWE. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Dana Brooke, ladies and gentlemen. Will she win here tonight? It's the real question. We gonna find out. We gonna find out if she gonna be able to win this. And there is Dana to the Brooke. She's a part of Titus Worldwide. Ladies and gentlemen, so the real question is, will she be able to win the women's champion? This show is actually almost over, by the way. I just realized that. I mean, this isn't anything new. We've been going for 36 minutes. Almost 37 right now. It's about to be 37 right now. So, yeah. We've been going for like 37 minutes. But still, it's a little weird. I don't know. It's something about it. It's something about it. Yeah, that's Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen. It's brought to you by... Yeah, this Monday Night Raw is brought to you by, I don't know what's brought to you by. Y'all let me know, what y'all want to be brought to you by. Cause I don't know, we had to have a sponsor for Extreme Rules. Cause Extreme Rules! Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, Ember Moon and Dana Brooke. Ladies and gentlemen, she's just gonna turn her back. Oh, the disrespect to Ember Moon. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that was a stupid of her. Right there. Oh, dang. And a kick right to the face from Ember Moon. A kick right to the face to Dana Brooke from Ember Moon, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. And Ember Moon. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Ember Moon. Ember Moon screaming. Ember Moon actually had one of the best performances in the Women's Money in the Bank match, by the way. Oh, it was amazing to watch. But wait a minute. Here we go. Look at that. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. Oh, look at that. Both of those moves are pretty awesome to see. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, that must hurt to have that right there to the abdomen right there. Here we go. And now Dana Brooke cannot find it. Oh, wait, never mind. I was getting ready to say she can't find an answer, but now she's coming back now. Look at that. So now, oh, and a chop right there to Ember Moon. And now Ember Moon has to, oh, get up and do something about it. She has to come back here. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. And look at that. And oh, and she throws her down. Here we go, and oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at this. Wait a second, look at us moving. Oh, and Ember Moon gets her again. Ember Moon is not playing any games, by the way. And ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Ember Moon throws it to the outside. Here we go, and Ember Moon, look at the. Oh, wait a minute, look at Ember and Dana Brooke and Ember Moon not doing the best of their abilities. And here we go, now Dana Brooke up on the top. She has to wait for her to do something. Here we go. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And, oh, and look at that leap from Dana Brooke. And what a leap from Dana, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. Oh, wait a second. Look at this. Look at this right here. And, oh, and Dana Brooke. And Dana Brooke here. Here we go. And look at this. And, oh, and here we go with Ember Moon. Ember Moon here. Gets a suplex right there to Dana Brooke. And now Dana Brooke's in deep trouble again. Oh, man. She has to find a way. She has to find a way. Find a way. Oh, dang. That was right to the throat, by the way. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Now Dana Brooke throws it to the corner. For no apparent reason, by the way. Here we go. And now Dana. Oh, and dang. That must have hurt. Oh, and an elbow. Collar and elbow. And ladies and gentlemen, she's like, no, not today. We're not going to do that whole tag team match shindig where we actually have to keep on going outside the ring for no reason. Look at this. Ember Moon in deep trouble. Oh, look at the strength of Dana Brooke. Dana Brooke, look at the power of Dana Brooke, ladies and gentlemen. What a move. What a move. Here we go. One hook of the leg. No, it's a kick out from Dana. I mean, from Ember. I'm sorry. From Ember Moon, ladies and gentlemen. Ember Moon has to find an answer. She has to find a way to possibly win this match. Just so she can go to Extreme Rules, because how awesome will it be to see Ember Moon and Asuka in an Extreme Rules match? That'd be pretty darn cool to see. That'd be pretty cool. They're pretty darn cool. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go, and Dana Brooke here, and Dana Brooke is just getting manhandled. Here we go. Now Ember Moon is at the top. She's just waiting for her. Oh, for her opponent to set up, but no, that did not happen. Here we go. What is going on? Oh, and a neck breaker, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, she's just doing it right now. Ladies and gentlemen, rats right there. Oh, wait there. God. Oh, gentlemen. Oh no, Ember's in trouble. Ember, and she falls hurt. Oh wait a minute. Look at that from the. That must have had to hurt, gentlemen. That had to hurt. One leg. No, and Brooke shocked. Shocked by the kick out. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Oh no. Oh. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, look at this right here. Oh, wait a minute. And Ember Moon with a neck breaker, ladies and gentlemen, to get out of it. Here we go. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Ember Moon catches her right there. One hook of the leg. And no, that's not going to be a three out just yet. And ladies and gentlemen, what a kick out. What a kick out from Dana Brooke. And Dana Brooke was not going to be over right there. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, what a great block from her. What a great block. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. And a roll up. A roll up. One, two. She has that leg hooked. And now it's a kick out. And, oh, man. Ember Moon is a little bit kind of scared. She probably had the fear right there after all that. Ladies and gentlemen, she's going around. And look at this. Oh, great move from Dana Brooke. And now Dana, big girl, is going to the top. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Oh, wait a minute, and oh, you see, she was trying to do the Becky Lynch, but you see, that you shouldn't do that because that can mess you up right there. Here we go, and oh, an Ember Moon. An Ember Moon, ladies and gentlemen. She's going to the top. What does she have in store? What does she have in store right now? And now she's taunting. She's taunting now, ladies and gentlemen. She's taunting right now. Oh, wait a minute, she just realized. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen, she realized right now what she's in store for. She realized that she's not going to do it. She's taunting at her, ladies and gentlemen. She's taunting at Ember Moon. She's telling her to come down. Oh, wait a second, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my God. And he clips, ladies and gentlemen, from the top rope. I was not expecting to see that from Ember Moon. What in the world, Ember? She probably just hurt her backside from that. Ladies and gentlemen, oh, my God. Oh, my. Wait, oh my! Ladies and gentlemen, that had to hurt. That has to be it. One, hook of the leg. Three, no! And Dana Brooke still kicks out. What in the world? Ladies and gentlemen, what the heck just happened? She just did the eclipse to the outside. To the outside, ladies and gentlemen, but it didn't work, unfortunately, in her favor. And here we go. Ember Moon! Oh, man, Ember Moon misses wildly right there. Here we go. Look at this. Dana Brooke, and Dana just loves her in the back area of her wrestlers. I mean, of her opponents, I might have said, not her wrestlers. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at the start right there. Oh, man. And wait a minute. Here we go. And now Ember Moon. Ember Moon here, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, oh, oh! Ladies and gentlemen, the ref. The ref's been knocked down. She doesn't realize it. That's a one, that's a two, that's a three. Come on, she should be the winner right now. Come on. And ladies and gentlemen, she just realized the referee was out. She just realized, I think she kicked the referee by accident at the same time. Now she's checking on the ref to make sure he's okay. And now the ref now is perfectly fine. Oh, wait a second, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. Oh no, and oh, look at this. Oh no, she's in deep trouble. Oh no, ladies and gentlemen, Ember Moon. Ember Moon here, Ember. She falls hard. Oh, look at this. Here we go. Oh, oh, ladies and gentlemen, she missed wildly. Oh, and a clothesline. Oh man, what a great clothesline. What a great clothesline, ladies and gentlemen. From Dana Brooke, and here we go. Oh, oh, ladies and gentlemen, oh. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Ember Moon. Ember Moon here. Ember Moon. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this move. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, oh, oh. Ladies and gentlemen. Ember Moon. Ember Moon to the top. Ember Moon to the top here. Ember Moon with the eclipse. Ladies and gentlemen, here on Monday Night Raw. Here's the pin. One. hook at a leg. It's a three count. She's going, and she advances the next week on Monday Night Raw. What a win from Ember Moon. What a win from Ember Moon. Oh, my. And ladies and gentlemen, Ember Moon advances to Monday Night Raw next week. And wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. She wants to... She's giving a handshake to... That's what I like to see from Dana Brooke. That's what I like to see. Dana, you was very close. You could have had it. Great respect for these two women, ladies and gentlemen. They both respect each other in this match, and that's what I like to see. But Ember Moon, ladies and gentlemen, advances to next week's Monday Night Raw for the Raw Women's Championship No More Contenders match. And I cannot wait to see who will be the victor in that match. This is actually a pretty decent match, too, actually. That's pretty good. Pretty good. I liked it. But great finish. I don't know why Dana Brooke was going to try to reverse it, but that didn't work out for her. She actually did have a chance to go and get her, though. But that's okay. Anywho, ladies and gentlemen, we're not even going to entertain them. But ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, up next. Oh. 1 second. All right, there's something going on here. There's something on. What just happened? The heck? Oh, fine. Please, all right, we apologize for that. But anyways, like we were trying to say, in the first place, up next time, up next is Matt Hardy or. The Woken Brothers. Aside for Matt Hardy versus Johnny Gargano, gentlemen, or Gargano. But that's up next here on Monday night. That's to the Raw. Can't wait to see who will win this match here tonight here on Raw, ladies and gentlemen. Up next. Yeah. Oh, it's a gentleman ticking. Come on. Wow. Ticking, ladies and gentlemen. This is ticking. And ladies and gentlemen, there is Matt Hardy, ladies and gentlemen, the Woken Matt Hardy. He is Woken. He is awoken here tonight. All right, how many times am I going to say he's awoken? I'm my bad. I don't want to apologize for that, but he has awoken here tonight here on Raw, ladies and gentlemen. This actually does a really one-off match. This actually isn't anything special. This is just a one-off match right now. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Matt Hardy, what a superstar, ladies and gentlemen. He is along with Bray Wyatt. Yeah, they actually did form a tag team, by the way, while I was not recording anything. But there is Bray Wyatt. He is outside of the ring, ladies and gentlemen. They have not won the tag team champions, though. That would be pretty cool, but that did not go down. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. There is Johnny Gargano. And this is the man who has been the rising star of Monday Night's The Raw for the past few weeks. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we do have something special coming up later this year with 2K19. I'm not going to say what it's going to exactly be or who I'm talking to with it, but I'm just going to leave it at that. Something special going on. If the rumors for 2K19 is true, one of the rumors, but it's something I want to do or we're going to do, and we're gonna see how it pans. That's what I meant to say. How it pans out. Not how it plans out. We're going to see how it pans out. That's what I was trying to say. But ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Gargano here tonight on Monday Night Raw going against Woken Matt Hardy. By the way, both of these guys are actually face. They're not heel. So I just want to let everybody know that. Matt Hardy's not a heel. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is. Johnny Gargano and Woken Matt Hardy. He has Woken. He's bloken. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here is the collar. Collar and elbow tie up. Here we go. And wait a minute, Matt Hardy now gets him now. Wait a second now. Oh, wait a second. Oh, look at that move right there. And now he's in the driver's seat. He can't find an answer. Oh, wait a minute. And Matt Hardy gets him down now. And he's not playing no games with Johnny here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, here's Johnny. Wait a minute. And Johnny gets him right in the face. Here we go. Reversal now. And, oh, what a great move right there from Johnny Gargano, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, he just kicking him in the face. The disrespect from Johnny. Is Johnny in the sprites right now? Wait a minute. Oh, here we go. And Matt Hardy. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Ah, yes. Matt Hardy. And Matt Hardy, ladies and gentlemen, doing some work here tonight, here on Monday. Oh, wait a minute. Look at us. Look at us right here. Look at Johnny. And Johnny, ladies and gentlemen. Johnny in the sprites. And ladies and gentlemen, he's mad that that just happened to him. I would be mad too. And there we go. And now he's taunting to get Matt Hardy possibly mad a little bit. And wait a minute. Here we go. Oh, and he messed up right there. Oh, look at that. Oh, he messed up. I keep on saying oh. Like 27. Here we go. Look at this. DDT. And a DDT from Matt Hardy. And now, here we go. Oh, wait a minute. Reversal right there. Wait a minute. Look at this move. And he has the neck. Oh, he was just holding on to dear life for that. Oh, reversal. Oh, and, oh, ladies and gentlemen, he kicked him like sideways a little bit. Oh, he tried to get him, and now Johnny and the sprites cannot get in the ring. Or he's going to try to get in the ring right now. But ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Suplex. No, it's going to be reversal. It's the same thing that Billy Kay did earlier. And now look at this. Look at this. Oh, dang. He actually had his arms around his neck. That must have hurt. Here we go. And Johnny gets a suplex right over there to the corner. This could be it for Matt Hardy early on. Here is the pin. Two. No, it's Matt Hardy who kicks out right now. Here we go. And he goes to the corner. Oh, I mean, he goes to the rope, man. I say not the corner. He went to the rope to go do an X handle to the back of Matt Hardy. And now suplex incoming from, oh, Johnny Gargano, ladies and gentlemen. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you for joining us here tonight on Monday Night Raw Live from Grand Rapids, Michigan. It has been a pretty decent night here on Raw. It's been the most random Monday Night Raw, but a pretty decent one at that. And do not forget, ladies and gentlemen, that the main event, which is up next, who will determine to go against Brock Lesnar at the Extreme Rules pay-per-view next month. Will it be Roman Reigns? Will it be Dean Ambrose? Will it be Cody Rhodes, or will it be the Monster Among Men, Braun Strowman? And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Look at it. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, he was going for something there. Matt Hardy is going to be coming to the rescue for that one. Oh, wait a second. Oh, look at that right there. And now Johnny Gargano gets him now. Right there at the top. Oh, no. Here we go. And oh, ladies and gentlemen, what a move from Johnny. Here's the pinfall. One. This could be it. Noah's a kick out from Matt Hardy here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And by the way, next week here on Monday Night Raw, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to come from you live from San Diego, California, from the Valley View Casino Center. Wait a minute. Matt Hardy now. Matt Hardy coming from behind. Boom! And Matt Hardy. What a good one, ladies and gentlemen. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, next week, for the next 4 weeks, we're actually going to show you the schedule for Monday Night Raw. We'll be in the Valley View Center. I mean, Valley View Casino Center in San Diego, California for the June 25th episode of Monday Night Raw. And then the week after, we'll actually be in South Dakota. Hold on a second. There's an advertisement for some weird reason. We'll be in South Dakota. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Look at Matt. Look at Matt Hardy. Oh, and Matt Hardy just hit him with a steel chair. For no, what in the world, Matt? One, hook of the leg. Now it's a kick out still from Johnny. And ladies and gentlemen, Matt Hardy is trying to do anything. But ladies and gentlemen, yeah, we'll be inside South Dakota, ladies and gentlemen, inside Sucks Falls, South Dakota. Oh, and a Denny Sanford Premier Center. Sorry, I couldn't actually say the thing. I was actually trying to pay attention to the mask at the same time. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. Oh, and he tried to reverse that, but he could not get it done. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Matt Hardy's just in the driver's seat right now, not playing any games. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, then the week after, which is the third week, we'll actually be inside Boston, Massachusetts in the TD Garden, ladies and gentlemen, which will be the last Monday Night Raw before Extreme Rules, which will be coming to you live from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, ladies and gentlemen, inside the PPG Center. And then the night after, hold on, the night after, I have to look it up because of things acting slow. Hold on. Here we go. Look at Matt. Oh, and Matt Hardy with a leg drop. First of all, he is like, what was I going to say? This man cannot find an answer to Johnny Gargano. Oh, he's just not finding an answer ever since that time. Oh, wait a minute. And now, oh, and he catches him from behind. Oh, wait a minute. Bray Wyatt is distracting him again. Wait a minute. He doesn't realize. Here's a roll up from Matt Hardy. Here's a pin. One. Hook of the leg. Three. Now it's a kick out still. But by the way, we're going to be inside the Key Bank Center. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, and a clothesline from Buffalo, New York. Sorry. But yeah, that'll be the night after of Extreme Rules. I couldn't get my words on. I'm very sorry about that. But here we go. Johnny Gargano's now coming back now. Here we go. Oh, and that's a gurry right to the head of Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy cannot find an answer. Now it's time for Johnny Gargano to come back now. Look at this. Look at this man. Here we go. Look at him. Oh, and oh my God, a frog splash from the top. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Did you see the height, by the way, from that frog splash? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, he even showed off to Bray Wyatt, showing him. Oh, wait a minute. Bray Wyatt's out. Wait a minute. Bray Wyatt's being kicked out. He's being kicked out. Oh, no. Oh, no, ladies and gentlemen, Bray Wyatt's being kicked out. Bray Wyatt's being kicked out now. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, he reverses it. Now Matt Hardy's mine. Here we go. Oh, and Matt Hardy's mad now, ladies and gentlemen, because his partner in crime has left. Look at this from Matt. Matt Hardy, ladies and gentlemen. Now he wants him to get up. He's putting his arms out like, ah, yes, get up. Here we go. And now Matt cannot find an answer. I mean, Johnny cannot find an answer. Here we go. Here we go. Look at Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy, ladies and gentlemen. What a great move. Here's the pin. One, two. No, it's a kick out from Matt Hardy. I mean, from Johnny Gargano. I keep on saying Matt freaking Hardy for some reason. Here we go. Look at this. Lifts him up. Oh, wait a minute. Reversal there. Oh, and a drop kick right there from Johnny. Great job from Johnny Gargano, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Wait a minute. He's pulling him over. He's pulling him over for something here. Wait a minute. What is he doing? What is he doing? Oh, wait a second, ladies and gentlemen. And he has Matt. He has Matt. Will Matt tap out? Will Matt tap out? Will Matt tap out? Oh, no. Oh, man, ladies and gentlemen, Matt Hardy, he might be donezo. He might be donezo. He might be donezo right here. Will Matt tap? Will Matt tap? Will Matt tap out, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, no, and Matt Hardy taps out. And it's over. Johnny Gargano is the winner tonight on Raw. And what a win from Johnny. What a win from Johnny and the Sprites here tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, wait a second. He wants to give a handshake to Matt Hardy. And Matt Hardy does accept the handshake. And he respected him. That's what I like to see, ladies and gentlemen. I know we do this all the time. This is like the most cliche thing that always happens on Universe Mode. But congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. I told you he wasn't a bad guy. He was a good guy. Even though Bray Wyatt actually helped him out. And he actually made him still a chair. But that's beside the point, ladies and gentlemen. That is extremely beside the point. That does not matter in this whole situation right now. That does not matter. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next here on Monday to the 9th to the Raw, it is time for the main event of the evening. It is time for lovely, lovely, lovely Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, Cody Rhodes, or Braun Strowman will go at it here tonight, here on Monday Night Raw. Who is going to win the match? Who's going to go to Extreme Rules and go against Brock Lesnar? We're going to find out. I can't wait to see who it's going to be. I can't wait to see, honestly. That's going to be pretty darn exciting. Ladies and gentlemen, that'll be up next, ladies and gentlemen, and it's time for a main event. As we say, it's main event time, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't even matter how long this match is going to be, honestly. as long as we get a... By the way, ladies and gentlemen, just to let everybody know, next week, Mr. Money in the Bank, Seth Rollins, will be in a match. Next week here on Raw, we have no idea who he's going to be going against, though. But we're going to find out who's going to be, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to find out for the very last time. We're going to find out who it is, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot wait to see who is going to be the superstar to go one-on-one with that man. We're going to find out. Seth Rollins will be back, ladies and gentlemen, next Monday Night Raw. So we want to apologize for him not being here, even though he's Mr. Money to Bank. So it's kind of ironic, actually. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. I'm excited. Ooh! Here's Roman Reigns, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. The underdog, Roman Reigns. There's a man that technically kind of turned heel for some weird reason. We don't know. We don't quite know why he turned heel. We don't quite understand the reason. It's kind of messed up, to be honest. Sorry, I was like, ladies, I was extending them something, but and Brock Lesnar, it's kind of weird because that's kind of like a real life rivalry, but and plenty of people have seen that like millions and millions and millions of times. So if Roman wins, I'll be a little ticked. I ain't gonna lie, that's the only prince I'll be kind of ticked if he won. Because like, how many times have you won against Brock Lesnar? Well, actually, 3 times actually. It was WrestleMania 31, WrestleMania 34, and then Greatest Royal Rumble. That was about it, but. Other than that, still kind of annoying. But apparently no one likes Roman Reigns. Kind of a bad for the poor man. No one cares about him. No one likes him. And here comes his old partner, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Ambrose. I don't really think that they broke up. I think what kind of happened is from my perspective of Roman Reigns is that it seemed like he just pretty much wanted to show the world him, even though that's kind of what they've been doing for the past like 4 years ever since they broke up in the first place. So I don't really know why that was kind of a thing, why that was even mentioned to begin with. I don't quite understand. I didn't really quite understand the whole concept, but that's okay. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes the returning monster among men. Here is Braun to the Strowman. Here he is in the flesh. Braun Strowman. The fans love him. Just listen to everybody. Fans absolutely love this man, Braun Strowman. And they are happy to see that he is back here on Monday Night Raw. I know I am. Well, it's giving me goosebumps. It's just giving me goosebumps here tonight, here on Raw. I'm excited. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Cody Rhodes, ladies and gentlemen. He is back here in the WWE. And the real question is, will he win this match for the Bullet Club? Because Finn Balor was unable to do it. He's not even here tonight, by the way. As you clearly see. But is Cody Rhodes, ladies and gentlemen, the returning Cody Rhodes, is he eligible to be WWE champion once again? We're going to find out here tonight on Monday Night Raw. But it's good to see Cody Rhodes back here in the WWE. Very good to see him back. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Now Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, Braun Strowman, and Cody Rhodes all in the ring, all ready to wrestle, all ready to fight to see who will be the number one contender, who is going to Extreme Rules. We're going to find out right now here on Monday Night Raw. Oh, wait a minute. Look at that submission from Cody Rhodes trying to end it early. Remember, this is false count anywhere, so anywhere go. I mean, anything goes. They can use weapons, which they can always win in Fatal 4 Ways, but still. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Look at this. Oh, and Braun Strowman taking out Roman Reigns outside the ring. He's probably mad about what happened in WrestleMania with that match. Look at this. Oh, and look at that from Cody Rhodes. Ladies and gentlemen, on to Dean Ambrose. Now Cody Rhodes and Dean Ambrose are going at it right now, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at that. Look at that suplex that just transpired right there. And oh, ladies and gentlemen, a clothesline right to the big man. To the monster among men here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, look at that hold right there. Oh, wait a minute. It's like an anaconda vice going on right there from Cody Rhodes. And a punch right to the stomach of Braun Strowman. And Dean Ambrose gets out of the hold, by the way. Dang, it's so hard when I'm watching the match because like I have to pay attention to like both things at the same time. Here we go. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, suplex. Oh, and a running bulldog. And now it's kind of weird because it seems like the Shield keeps on getting like back into place now. It's like when one of them's getting beat up, then the other's getting beat up, then when one of them's actually in the driver's seat, then the other one's in the driver's seat. It's like it keeps happening like that. Except for now. Now Dean Ambrose is in the driver's seat and Braun Strowman's in it. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. He's going to do and he gets a little bit of payback right there on Cody Rhodes of what Cody Rhodes did to him early on in the match. It's a little funny because, like, when it comes to Fatal 4-Way matches, for some weird reason, the computer always goes outside of the ring. Like, there's always two outside of the ring and then two inside. Which, in my opinion, doesn't make any darn sense. Like, that doesn't always happen. But, alright. No, I'm But, you know, I'm just saying. It doesn't really make sense to me. But, yeah, whatever. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, man, look at that, ladies and gentlemen. Great suplex from Cody Rhodes. From Dean Ambrose here. Oh God, I'm trying to like, oh, look at that move from Dean Ambrose right there, ladies and gentlemen. This is a great back and forth match between these superstars, these four men here tonight. Who's gonna go against Brock Lesnar? We're gonna find out very soon, ladies and gentlemen. I actually just cannot wait to see who is gonna be, ladies and gentlemen, even though everybody except for, Cody Rhodes has actually fought Brock Lesnar before, so that's the only thing, but here we go, and look at that superplex from Braun Strowman. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, now everybody's going outside of the ring. Wait a minute, look at Dean. Dean's doing something here. Look at this from Dean and Dean Ambrose, ladies and gentlemen. What a move, and ladies and gentlemen, by the way, Braun Strowman just did a signature to the outside of Roman Reigns, in case you missed it over there. Sorry, it was a cooler move that Dean Ambrose did out there. But wait a minute. And now Dean Ambrose is trying to... Oh, and Dean Ambrose gets demolished from Braun to the Strowman. Ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, Braun Strowman now has Dean Ambrose. And whoa, Dean Ambrose flips over. Whoa, look at this right here. And a suplex incoming. Oh, round of steel steps. That had to hurt. That hurt. My God, that hurt. That hurt a ton right there, ladies and gentlemen. That had to hurt. But ladies and gentlemen, look at this. Here we go. Dean Ambrose. Let's get him down, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, this is a little reminder. This is the main event of Monday Night Raw. We want to thank you guys again for joining us. And here we go. And look at this. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, a running bulldog once more. And now Cody Rhodes is coming after a little somebody. Oh, and a DDT to the outside. And wait a minute. Oh! He just made a fell. And ladies and gentlemen, Roman Reigns getting up now. Now he's running to the other side. Now, oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Look at all this. And now Roman Reigns. Wait a minute. Roman Reigns is paying attention. Oh, look at that, ladies and gentlemen. Now Roman Reigns is paying attention to Braun Strowman again. Now it's back to how it was in the first place. Look at all this. Just look at all this. Oh, man, ladies and gentlemen, look at this. And, ooh, ladies and gentlemen, what a move from Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose needs to chill. Dean Ambrose. Oh, wait a minute. Dean Ambrose is getting ready to do his finisher to Roman Reigns. He's going to do it not only to somebody, but to Roman Reigns' own bro. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Dirty D's to the outside. That hurts a lot more than inside the ring. Wait a minute. And oh, wait a minute. Braun. And Braun Strowman breaks up the pin early on, ladies and gentlemen. Good job from Braun for paying attention because most of the computer is really dumb. And oh, wait. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, they're doing a little bit of extreme moments, like unintentional extreme moments, actually. Like, out of nowhere. Ladies and gentlemen, what a match this is. They're all outside of the ring, ladies and gentlemen. They're not playing. Like, majority of this match is literally just a brawl more than an actual match. This looks straight up like a brawl. Ladies and gentlemen, this match has to end quick because, like, we're running out on space right now. And they're just taking their sweet behind time winning this match. Like, good God. Ladies and gentlemen, wait a minute. Does Dean have it? Oh, Dean Ambrose won! Oh! And Cody Rhodes, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, no. Cody, you was messed up. Ladies and gentlemen, Dean Ambrose going against Brock Lesnar for the WWE Universal Champion, ladies and gentlemen. I was not expecting to see that happen. Oh, no. Oh, no. Cody was being an idiot. Wasn't paying attention, like always. But Dean Ambrose is going to Extreme Rules. Unfortunately for the rest, man, I guess, what's his name shouldn't have done that. And now Dean Ambrose actually has a chance to get his rematch from TLC because he never actually had a title match, a title rematch, actually, at least a title rematch, that is, as of late. So that's kind of unfortunate, but now he has a chance. He is going, ladies and gentlemen, he is going to Extreme Rules. And he's going to fight for the Universal Championship. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching Monday Night Raw. And we'll see you tomorrow night on SmackDown. And what's going to happen between Brock Lesnar. And by the way, Brock Lesnar, I believe, will be here next week on Monday Night Raw as well as Seth Rollins. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you next week in San Diego, California. Good night, everybody. Ah!